So, ladies and gentlemen, a warm welcome from the headquarter from Obrist Powertrain here in the west of Austria. Within the next 20 minutes, I would like to talk about our zero vibration generator, the vibration-free, emission-minimized and sustainable solution for an electrified future. The presentation is structured, as you can see here. I will start with a short group introduction, followed by an explanation why we decided to develop a zero vibration generator. Then we will jump into the zero vibration generator technical deep dive with the technical highlights and USB, followed by test results. I will give you a cost overview, and I will close the presentation with a short conclusion and outlook. So where are we? We are a small group here, Obrist Group. We are working since 25 years of engineering of emission reduction. We have two main companies located in Austria. That's Obrist Engineering, working on thermal management, and Obrist Powertrain, working on hybrid powertrain system, including the zero vibration generator and battery system. This year, we have acquired the Felix Wankel Institute in Lindau at the Lake of Constance, where we founded the Obrist Germany. What was our motivation to develop an electric power unit? The reason was in 2011, we decided to develop a new powertrain system. It's a serial hybrid system currently called Electric Vehicle 2.0, is a serial hybrid system with the main target to develop a price comparable powertrain system compared to conventional gas diesel drive teams with a superior NVH behavior. So we wanted to support BEV driving behavior with a hybrid system. One big target is the ability to operate the system with gasoline and emission-free with green fuel like e-methanol. And finally, it should be a plug-in solution to overcome the problem with the range anxiety. We have an animation here. As you can see, we have built up a car with this system, representing this system. It's built in Tesla Model 3. The car is currently running here on the streets. As you can see, we have installed our ZVG 40 kilowatt electric output power in the front. We have used the electric drive of the vehicle. We have implemented our downsized battery system with 73.3 kilowatt hours to achieve the cost target and to enable us to go same driving performance as the original car. By changing the components, we only have the ability to go with higher system performances to show or to enable the system be used in vehicles on a higher performance level. So what is the zero vibration generator? We will now jump into the technical deep dive. On this slide, you can see the key effects of the engine. As we said, the engine is developed to be operated with conventional gasoline and emission-free with e-methanol. It's a naturally aspirated engine with multi-port injection, 1 liter volume. We can support 36 kilowatt electric output on gasoline and 42 on methanol, with an efficiency thermal side of 40% and 42%. This ends up at the DC output, that means fuel consumption compared to DC power, 30% for the gasoline and 34% for the methanol system. And the USP here, aside the efficiencies, is the full balancing of the system. So it's a zero vibrating combustion engine during operation. Here you can see the animation, how the system looks like. As we said, it's a very compact system, ready to be operated with gasoline and methanol. It's very compact with a weight of 110 kilograms. We have two counter-rotating crankshafts here to compensate the first order. It's a very simplified valve train and a new highly innovative compensation system for the second order operating on the camshaft. We have installed a rubber-damped gear on the second crankshaft to minimize the noise generated by the gear set. And we have a flywheel to compensate all inertias of rotating parts. It's a mass production design, so all the parts are designed in aluminum, ready for mass production. We have installed a dry sump lubrication for also a horizontal operating of the CVG. Then we have the inverter generator. We have a throttle valve, an integrated airbox with filter, and we have an acoustic insulation box. On the one side, we have the interfaces for the coolant. On the other side, the interfaces for the high-low voltage and the exhaust system. And as you can see here, the CVG comes with an integrated, highly compact exhaust system. So what are the USPs here? Zero vibration generator, that's the name because it's the worldwide only engine that runs totally out or free of vibrations. And this is done here with, on the one hand, the counter-rotating crankshafts. These counter-rotating crankshafts are balancing the first order to 100%, so we are totally free of these forces. And we are compensating the forces of second order by using our new compensation system. It's a mass spring system operated by the camshaft. And here on the table, you can see that all forces are eliminated. That's the theory behind it. You can see on the upper diagram in gray, in orange, you see the forces of the first order, in gray, the forces of the second order, and in blue, you see the summary of both forces. And with our compensation system of first and second order, this blue line goes down to the blue line you see in the bottom diagram, which is nearly zero. You see some small oscillations, and that's driven by the dynamic of the valve train system itself, which is driving the compensation system. And with this system, we are significantly better than a 12-cylinder engine, which is currently the benchmark for vibration and NVH. So with this system, we have compensated the forces, but we still have some external forces due to rolling moments. We have one generator, and during dynamic operation, acceleration, deceleration, we are generating external forces due to rolling moments. This is compensated by an internal flywheel. The benefit of this system is we are not only compensating the generator, we are also compensating all rolling moments of the auxiliaries installed, which is the oil system with the oil pump and the valve train. So all rotating parts here are compensating by the flywheel, so we are totally force-free to the outside. And this was the theory. The practical part here, you see a startup of the engine at AVL test bench. We are starting the CVG up to 1300. You see no vibration. There is a glass in the background. Sorry for the focus here. But also all the lines around, you see no vibrating, no movement, nothing. We are ramping up the CVG to 3000 RPM. Nothing happens. It's totally vibration free. Then we go down to 1500, back to the minimum speed for the CVG, and then we turn it off. And you see through the whole procedure, starting, dynamic up, dynamic down, turning off, nothing happens. So you see that the theory we have inside works perfectly well. Another point here, another innovative point is the compensation of the noise of the gear set. As you see, the whole system or the generator is driven by a gear train. We have installed a steel cartridge, which is keeping the gear train here and decoupling the steel gear train from the aluminum housing to be totally compensated or free from the elongation of the aluminum housing. And that enables us to keep a constant tooth clearance through the whole operating range. And additionally, we have installed a rubber damped gear on the second crankshaft to maximize the noise damping value and to minimize the stiffness to the whole system, and damping also the noise path from the gear to the housing. And this allows us to minimize the noise generation of the gear train during operation. Another point here is noise and emission. If you recall, the engine looks like a shoebox, and the reason is the design was chosen because we are covering the whole engine with a shoebox. So that's a noise box which is covering the whole system with access to all the service parts, and this gives us an additional damping of the noises during operation generated by the CVG. And regarding emissions, we have a compact exhaust system, the current design here with 10 liters to fulfill the tailpipe noise targets. The silencer here carries also the catalytic converter, and the catalytic converter is fitted with an electrical heating element to enable us to fulfill the RDE emission targets by applying a heating strategy for the system. We are operating the CVG at lambda 1, and we have a multi-port injection, which gives us a benefit regarding particular matters. One point here is the focus, and that's very important for us for the operation of green fuel, especially methanol. As I said, the CVG is designed to operate with gasoline, but also with methanol. For gasoline, we have a compression ratio of 12.5. You see the piston on the left-hand side. And for my methanol, we went up to a compression ratio of 20:1. You can also see the design of the piston for methanol. This is possible here for methanol due to the high knocking resistance of methanol, and that enabled us also to further increase the efficiency of the whole system. From a mechanical point of view, we do have much, much higher load, peak pressure load for methanol. We have 65 for gasoline, 115 for methanol. So the whole engine is designed to withstand the 150 bars, so you can operate the engine with both fuels. And additionally, we have installed an electrically heated fuel rail to heat up the fuel, especially the methanol, under cold condition to ensure a perfect fuel spray behavior. Test results. We have done some testings here. We have tested the engine with both fuels. On the left-hand side, you see a gasoline, 95 octane, where we ended up with a power output of 48 indicated and something like 38 on the DC side. So our target here is 40 kilowatt. On the methanol side, we were able to increase the performance indicated above 50. And on the DC side, we reached 42. The target here is 45 kilowatt, and within the next weeks, we will do some optimization loops to achieve the target values. On this slide, you can see the efficiency maps. So on the left-hand side, you see efficiency for gasoline, right-hand side, e-methanol. On the top line, it's the thermal efficiency. On the bottom line, the DC. For gasoline, you see we have best points of 40% efficiency for thermal. On the DC side, it's 30%. That's including the internal friction, the gear set, the inverter and generator efficiency. And on the right-hand side, for methanol, we have achieved 43% in the best point for thermal and 36% for the DC. We have inserted the blue line, so this will be the operating line for our ZVG, starting from the minimum speed up to maximum, and that's a compromise or a balance between best efficiency and best NVH behavior due to throttling benefits we can gain. If you want to go in best point, you would follow the full load line here, but we do a compromise between efficiency and noise. The benefit here is we have a very, very continuous efficiency through all the operating points. This enables us to go this strategy. The next point is focusing on cost. Together with our partner, Polarix partner, we have done a cost calculation for this mass production ready B sample. They have calculated the main parts here of the ZVG. The remaining parts have been estimated and calculated with volume production suppliers. And as you can see here, the calculation was done for 250,000 units per year for a production period of 8 years. And with this assumption, we end up with a production cost target of 948 euros, including the whole engine, the exhaust system, and the insulation box. The three-way catalytic converter is not included due to the fact that currently the values for the coating material is rapidly changing, and that's the reason why we have removed the value here to not running into an issue with changing costs. Okay, conclusion and outlook. So we have built up the Model 3 here with our system, with the A-sample. We are now building up a Tesla Model Y called Electric Vehicle 2.0 with the ZVG B-sample. We are pretty sure and convinced that the Paris targets 2015 requires automotive electrification. The electric vehicle 2.0 shows an affordable solution with extremely high efficiencies. That means low consumption values. With the system, we can ensure or show a pure electric driving behavior even in hybrid mode, and this is possible by the application or the use of the zero vibration generator. And with this system, we can operate the electric vehicle 2.0 with the green fuel e-methanol, and that means we have a CO2 free and emission minimized operation of the system. We will have this vehicle available second half of this year, so you're all highly welcome to contact us and to drive, to discuss the technology and also driving the vehicle here in Lustenau or at your site. So thank you very much for your attention, and I think we should have now exactly 10 minutes remaining for your questions. Thank you very much.